Me by Zora Neale Hurston.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am Brenda Johnson, your host for today's event. A salute to the Harlem Renaissance and the Black Arts Movement, sponsored by Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated, Omicron Chi Omega Chapter here in Woodbridge, Virginia. It is so wonderful to be a part of the arts, where young and vibrant individuals have an opportunity to showcase their talents. Thank you for tuning in today. We have an exciting program for you. Today, we are in our final episode of A Salute to the Harlem Renaissance. Our theme today is Excellence Unmasked. Before we move on, I would like to introduce and welcome Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated Omicron Chi Omega Chapter President, Mrs. Christina Henry Robeson, to greet you. Mrs. Robeson was recently installed as our president of the chapter, and she is no stranger to this program. She was the past vice president responsible for programs, and she did a marvelous job. Mrs. Robeson has some words of welcome for you.
Thank you, Ms. Brenda Johnson. On behalf of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Omicron Chi Omega Chapter, I want to welcome and thank each of you for your presence here today. One of the key target areas under the leadership of our international president, Dr. Glenda Glover, is the arts. The purpose of this program is to expose students to the arts, enrichment, and culture by focusing on visual and performing arts and by showcasing talent through the exploration of writers, entertainers, and various artists. Today, for the fourth year in a row, Omicron Chi Omega's Arts Committee will showcase youth from the DMV area who have skills in the arts and with a focus in the Harlem Renaissance and the Black Arts Movement. The students you see today have a deep passion for the arts and are excited to showcase their talents. So sit back, relax, and enjoy today's program.
Thank you, Mrs. Robeson, for your welcome. In this area, Virginia, DC, Maryland, there are so many theaters, to include the world's well-known John F. Kennedy Center. In the Prince William County area, there is the well-known Creative and Performing Arts Center and the Art Council that displays so many talent. Not so well-known is Target 4, this program. However, we provide opportunities for so many students over the last 4 years to present their talents, their visual arts, their music, their dramatic performances, and we have been blessed for this. We believe that this program is part of starting them on their way to the JF Kennedy Center, Juilliard, having their paintings in some of the world's famous galleries in the country, and more. Students, on your way there, don't forget to add this program as part of your portfolio. The Harlem Renaissance and the Black Arts Movement have been publicized and talked about since these eras ended because they both had such an impact on where we are today in the expression of African American art. As a refresher, let's look back for a moment of what these two eras were about. As a disclaimer, we use these videos from the internet and we have no claim of ownership or authoring of the content. We simply want to show you the information, and you may search on the website for this information as well.
Throughout the 1920s, Harlem experienced a cultural and intellectual explosion that became known as the Harlem Renaissance. Who was involved in the Harlem Renaissance? What was the ultimate impact? Harlem is a neighborhood in New York City which has a very large African American community. Harlem became a destination for African Americans throughout the early 1900s as part of the Great Migration. As more blacks made Harlem their home, it increasingly became well known as an African American cultural center. Poets, writers, artists, musicians, and philosophers were all key parts of the movement. One of the key components of the Harlem Renaissance was music. Jazz performers including Jelly Roll Morton, Fats Waller, Duke Ellington, and Louis Armstrong perfected their music, which became very popular amongst white audiences. It was also during this era when the piano was incorporated into the jazz style of music. Traditionally, jazz bands had included primarily brass instruments. Intellectuals such as W.E.B. Du Bois and Marcus Garvey argued and debated issues of racism, ethnic pride, and other topics related to African American life. Poets such as Langston Hughes introduced a new form of poetry known as jazz poetry. African American literature of the era included themes such as how slavery had impacted the African American culture and how to combat stereotypes of Black Americans. African American clothing also drastically changed during the Harlem Renaissance. Black men started wearing zoot suits. These were suits which featured long coats with padded shoulders and wide lapels. Women wore low-slung dresses, silk stockings, and open-toed slippers. Both genders wore hats with wide brims. Leopard skin items also became popular, as they were seen as a connection to traditional African garb. The Harlem Renaissance had a profound impact on the United States, as well as the world. African American artists, musicians, and writers began to be respected on an international level. Not only were white audiences listening to and enjoying Black music, but white composers and musicians began incorporating African American rhythms and harmonies into their own pieces. The Harlem Renaissance also helped to change the world's perception of African Americans. Prior to the 1920s, Blacks were thought of as uneducated farmers. However, thanks to the Harlem Renaissance, a new image of sophisticated and intellectual African Americans began to emerge.
The Black Arts Movement. The Black Arts Movement made a significant contribution to the history of American society and to the African American community. It not only catered to the arts, but the Black Arts Movement during the 1960s and 1970s was a political, social, and economical movement for the community. Following the death of Malcolm X and stemming from the Black Power Movement, the Black Arts Movement charged all avenues of art, including visual artists and literal artists, to socially and politically connect the Black audience to Black art. The Black Power Movement sparked a radical political and social revolution in American society by the Black community. The Black Power Movement is often recognized or associated with the legendary Black Fist and the iconic slogan, "Power to the People." Some individuals saw the movement as a positive approach to bridge equality between both Black and white races, while others viewed it as a militant, sometimes violent force aimed to create a distinct gap between the two races. With the help of social advocates Stokely Carmichael, Huey Newton, and Bobby Seale, the progress of the Black Power Movement began to skyrocket. Stokely Carmichael popularized the term Black Power, while Huey Newton and Bobby Seale formed the Black Panther Party for Self-Defense, commonly known as the Black Panther Party. Because of the Black Power Movement, the fuel was given to effectively drive the Black Arts Movement. Black artists were challenged yet committed into bringing the arts back to the Black urban neighborhoods. The Black Arts Movement reacquainted the Black community with both Black art and Black culture. There were many prominent figures, artists, and activists, such as Mary Baraka, founder of the Black Arts Movement, and poet Gwendolyn Brooks, who influenced and helped with leading the Black Arts Movement. Among those leaders, Larry Neal was also an important intellectual contributor to the movement. Neal believed that the Black Arts Movement was an ethical movement, asserting, "Your American cultural sensibility should be destroyed before the Black creative artists could have a meaningful role in the transformation of society." The Black Arts Movement produced many positive attributes to the Black community with the birth of the Black Arts Repertoire Theater School, new African American studies and programs for colleges and universities, and the production of works from poets and artists. The Black Arts Movement gave artists of all disciplines the opportunity to revive African American culture by channeling inner African roots and cultivating our own. The Black Arts Movement brought new energy to Black artists while awakening and reacquainting the Black community.
Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world's changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty.
I hope you have a better appreciation of these two eras and the significance. As Mrs. Robeson explained, the international president of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, at the beginning of her term, 4 years ago, designated the arts as an area she wanted to focus for our youth. Our program today is filled with some of the brightest and most talented youth you will find in the area. The archives, years from now, will show the talent from these various students. Our first presenter is Eugene Bartholomew. Eugene has been with the program for 4 years, and he has improved so much. Let's listen in on what he has for us today.
Thank you.
Eugene. Margaret Johnson is no stranger to having a mic in front of her. Charlie Parker will be impressed how she performs one of his styles of singing during the Harlem Renaissance era.
Whatever they be, you gotta make me a promise.
you, Kayla. Visual art is amazing. Ayana Rowe is also in her fourth year with this program. This year, she is presenting amazing art created on a computer. Thank you, Ayana. Ali Cypress is tiny, but have a big heart. This is her second year with us. Thank you, Allie. Lakeisha Vedike is gracing us with her tales of two women.
I'm Lake Patihe, and this is my piece, Elise. I wanted to capture a feeling of tranquility, but also of sadness with this piece, with the focus Elise facing away from the light source and kind of folded into herself. This piece doesn't really have a direct connection with the Harlem Renaissance. I just wanted to make a painting of a woman who was placed in that era. This is my piece, The Little Girl Blue, inspired by a song, specifically the cover by Sarah Vaughan going by the same name. The story behind this painting is there's a girl who is really inspired by the jazz singers in her day, the uprising of Harlem. And things like that. So this is just her imagining herself on stage, covered in blue light, representing, you know, the blues. And the background, which is bright red, is supposed to represent the harshness of the world around her and kind of how she contrasts it with her passion for wanting to be a singer.
Thank you, Lakeisha. We're having so much fun so far, don't you think? Our students are our greatest asset because they are our future. So let's move on. Nicholas McCaddy. Nicholas has been with us for 4 years. He has an outstanding voice and he loves to sing. So let's hear him now in his last rendition for us for this program. We wish him well.
I see shattered, you see whole. I see broken, you see beautiful, and you're helping me to believe, 'cause you're restoring me piece by piece. There's nothing too dirty.
and there's nothing too dirty that you can't make worthy. You washed me in mercy. I am clean. Oh yeah. Oh, what was dead now lives again. My heart's beating inside my chest, and I'm coming alive with joy and destiny. Whoa, 'cause you're restoring me piece by piece. There's nothing too dirty that you can't make worthy. You washed me in mercy. I am clean. Oh yeah. There's nothing too dirty that you can't make worthy. You washed me in mercy. I am clean. Washed in the blood of your sacrifice, your blood poured red and made me white. My dirty rags are purified. I am clean. Oh yes. Washed in the blood of your sacrifice, your blood poured red and made me white. My dirty rags are purified. I'm clean, I'm clean. Oh, washed in the blood of your sacrifice, your blood poured red and made me white. My dirty rags are purified. I'm clean, I'm clean. Oh, I'm clean. Oh, you made me, you washed me clean. Yes, you washed me, you made me, and you washed me clean. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicholas. Nyla Farmer. Dancing is a great art form. I like to dance also. However, Nyla is a dancer.
I love to see black men in chains. From the transatlantic slave trade to modern day mass incarceration, the old and the new Jim Crow remain. They love the normalization of our oppression and the way the system keeps the oppressed so tame. They love when Sam Cooke sings about change. So as long as words don't manifest to things, they love the way we wait for change, the way we beg for change, the way we slave 60 hours in a week for change, the way we rob, steal, and kill for change. They love our perpetual state of poverty. They love the way we sell our souls for cheese, the way we love the trap, the way we jig and bleed to the beats of gangster rap. They love Lil Wayne and 2 Chainz, both mental and physical. They love to see black men in 2 Chainz. They love love and hip-hop, especially when hip-hop keeps black bodies twerking and black minds deranged. They love our irony. the way we are economically crippled, that we raise every payday to feed the economy. They love our hyper-materialism and hyper-consumerism. They hate that the black man has that Mansa Musa in him. So they love to see black men in chains, but they hate to see black men as kings. They hate the hostility of El Hajj Malik Shabazz, but they love to quote Dr. King. They love Beyonce. Until Beyonce reverberated her people's pains, they hated formation. They hated when we are informed. They love to see black men in formation up until the Black Panthers reigned. Now they love to see black men in formation, but only in basketball games. They love to pack stadiums and clap for LeBron James, but the intellectual prowess of Langston drove them insane. They love to feed blacks misinformation, and they hate when our leaders make it plain. Because they love to see black men in bondage. But what they love most is when a black man slain.
By men of many nations and backgrounds. It was founded on the principle that all men are created equal, and that the rights of every man are diminished when the rights of one man are threatened.
Our people are dying slowly every day. The enemy's trying, attacking every way he can. We gotta fight, we gotta fight, we gotta fight. You see, in this generation, materialistic swallow the minds of these innocent children, yeah. We gotta fight, we gotta fight, we gotta fight. Oh, you see the third cry.
Cry, 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 cry
Elena Mitchell. Hear her play and remember her name when you see it one day in an official playbill. Elena, thank you. Margaret Johnson is coming to us again to take us back to the sounds of the Renaissance era.
Have you met Sir John? Someone said as we shook hands, he was just Sir Jones to me. Then I said, Sir Jones, you're a guy who understands. I'm a girl who must be free. And all at once I own the earth and sky. Now I've met Sir Jones, and we'll keep on meeting till we die. Sir Jones and I. Day-do-day, day-do-day, buffy, ba-do-da. Shadu body do dee do day. Shadu lo dee bo do dat. Dee lo booty bo ba booty dee a day. Ba do day.
diddle-oo-da-doo-dee-boo-beep. Rub-a-diddle-o-diddle-oo-dee-boo-beep. Ba-doo-da-ba-doo-boo-dee. Ba-doo-dee-doo-day. Ba-boo-dee. Have you met Sir Jones? Someone said as we shook hands, he was just Sir Jones to me. Then I said, Sir Jones, you look like a guy who might understand. I'm a girl who must be free. And all at once I lost my breath, and all at once was scared to death, and all at once I own the very earth and sky. Now I've met Sir Jones, and we'll keep on meeting till we die. Jones and I, Sir Jones and I, that's Sir Jones and I.
Thank you, Margaret. Jemiah Mark returns to the stage for her dramatization. Let's listen.
Hello, my name is Jemiah Mark, and I will be doing Mother to Son by Langston Hughes.
Well, son, I tell you, life for me ain't been no crystal stair. It had tacks in it, and splinters, and boards torn up, and places with no carpet on the floor, bare. But all the time, I still climbing on, and reaching landings and turning corners, and sometimes going in the dark when they never been no light. So boy, don't you turn back now. Don't you sit down on these steps, cause you find it's getting kinda harder. Don't fall back now, for I still going, honey. I still climbing on. And life for me ain't been no crystal stair.
Thank you.
Jemiah, thank you. Kennedy Mormon, remember when I said that one day you may be a part of JF Kennedy and other theaters? Well, Kennedy has been a part of the Creative and Performing Arts Center here in Woodbridge, Virginia. Let's listen in.
Fly to the sky.
Thank you, Kennedy. Gabrielle Williams graced us last year with her dragon artwork, and she is back to show us more. She has also included her piano piece. Gabrielle, although everything we have done here today is in reference to Black history. Our next presenter, Jacob Johnson, will do a Black history moment. Jacob Johnson.
Hi, my name is Jacob Johnson. I'm 13 years old. I attend Woodbridge Middle School, and I am in the 7th grade. Today, I'm going to be doing a report on John Lewis. John Robert Lewis was born February 21st, 1940, and died July 17th, 2020. The cause of his death was pancreatic cancer. John's parents were Willie Mae Carter and Eddie Lewis. His wife, Lillian Miles, was born 1968 and died 2012. His parents were sharecroppers, and he also attended a segregated school. John Lewis's son was named John Miles Lewis. John Lewis led the march on Edmund Pettus Bridge in Selma, Alabama in 1965, also known as Bloody Sunday. He studied nonviolent protests and became involved with sit-ins at lunch counters. He is important to African Americans because he gathered thousands of students across the South to march. He also helped with sit-in protests and civil rights movements. John Lewis is a member of the Democratic Party and was first elected to Congress in 1986. He spent 17 terms in the U.S. House of Representatives. John Lewis served as a senior chief deputy, Democratic whip, as a member of the Democratic Steering Committee, the Congressional Black Caucus, and the Congressional Committee to Support Writers and Journalists. Apart from his service as Congress, he was co-chair to the Faith in Politics Institute, U.S. Congressman John Robert Lewis.
Thank you, Jacob. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our program. Mrs. Robeson, your final remarks, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you have enjoyed today's program. This program has showcased the wonderful talents of our students, and we appreciate your attendance and support. To our students, I want to thank you for your participation in today's program and encourage you to continue to follow and craft your passion for the arts. The great Maya Angelou said, "Nothing can dim the light that shines within. Continue to let your light shine and strive for greatness." Finally, thank you to Ms. Brenda Johnson and the entire Arts Committee for a marvelous presentation. As the final curtain call, please take a virtual bow as you have executed in excellence here today. You have worked diligently over the past 4 years to educate our students on the Black Arts Movement. Thank you again, and I salute you for a job well done.
Thank you again, everyone, for supporting our programs over the years, and especially during our current environment where so much must be done virtually. I would like to thank my committee for working so diligently year after year to execute this program. Thank you to all our technical support teams for making this happen. It would not have happened without you. We appreciate you. Thank you to our parents. Parents, you are special because you have poured in the love and the encouragement to the students. And they have a village, I'm sure, that also works with them. I am sure that you, the parents, are so very proud of them. I am so very proud. Most important is our students. If no one knew that you had the talent that you have displayed here today, it definitely has been unmasked. Excellent unmasked. To all the students who have participated in this program since 2019, we thank you and appreciate you. Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Omicron Chi Omega Chapter, Target 4, The Art, has concluded its final episode of A Salute to the Harlem Renaissance and the Black Arts Movement. We bid you farewell. It has been so wonderful to have you share with us and see the talents of so many students. I am Mrs. Brenda Johnson, your host, the Arts Chairman, signing off. God bless and have a good day.